Do-rag wisdom, folks. Earth date Y2k17.08.23. And what advice, after 67 years on this planet, can I dare to have the audacity, the presumption to give anybody to stay young? What advice? How do you stay young? What I'm about to tell you, I don't completely follow all my own advice. I've tried throughout my life. There's always been a fight in me. How do I stay young? What advice can I give you? If I can give anybody any advice or dare to. Keep in touch with anything you liked when you were a kid. If most of your childhood was screwed up, I'm not saying you should concentrate on that, but remember the things you enjoyed. And this is where I learned from three of my favorite people, speculative fiction, quote-unquote science fiction writer Ray Bradbury, who is friends with special effects genius Ray Harryhausen, and he was friends, and also the two of those guys were friends with Forrest J. Ackerman, who later became the editor of Famous Monsters of Filmland, and he had an Acker Monster Museum, and they made a deal when they were kids to always love their monsters, to always love the stuff of fantasy, the supernatural, horror, the weird, and I always, and I'm thankful for my monsters. I have enough with the monsters of our real lives. The Donnie Trumps, the Pences, the Mike Pences, the Steve Mnuchins and his douchebag spouse. All the creeps that this piece of trash that is president, the real monster that is creepidin. I don't call him president, I call Trump birther bastard the creepidin, because this is the true monster. It's hard to hold on to your childhood when you have to deal with real monsters your whole life. All of us have to deal with the monsters, the real monsters throughout all our lives. So one way to be young, I hold on to the monsters that I grew up with. The Frankenstein monster, Count Dracula, the Wolfman, the creature from the Black Lagoon, the giant spiders, the It Came From Outer Spaces, the beasts from 20,000 Fathoms, the giant ants, the wonderful cyclopses, the dragons, the fantasy, the future worlds, the dystopian worlds I was introduced to when I was a kid. I still love all of this crazy stuff, I'm telling you. And I'm gonna hold on to it. And it makes me feel good that I feel still excited, you know, by the prospect of seeing the same monster movie I've seen many, many, many times before. So stay young by staying in touch with those stamp collections and those comic collections, or you have like your coin collection, whatever collection you have, whatever made you feel wonderful when you were growing up, hold on to that with your dear life. Don't just think of it as a money thing that you're gonna, you know, let that, pass it on to the people that are gonna follow you. You, me, enjoy your collection while you have it in your life, if you have that kind of thing. Enjoy your monsters while you have them, while you're alive. I mean, if that's what you did when you were a kid, And so you keep this in mind whenever you can. Avoid your automobile. All right. If you have to go out to the country, drive upstate someplace, or out of state, or across country, that's one thing. But if you can, when you're in the city, take your bike. Ride your bike. Take a walk. Walk to the subway station or the train station if you can. Walk or ride your bike. Use your body as much as you can. Use the stairway instead of the escalator. If you can avoid the elevator, avoid it. If the stairways are safe, use them. Be thankful that you have a physical body to use and take advantage every second that you have it. And of course, use your brain too. And do puzzles, get involved in projects. I mean, give yourself something to read. Always be informed, never be ignorant. Learn all kinds of new ideas, learn to use new technology. All in the idea of staying young, keeping vibrant, keeping that brain, that noodle. And the puzzles, yeah, do puzzles. You like puzzles, play games, but concentrate on the brain games if you can. You know, chess, backgammon, word search, solitaire, mahjong solitaire. Learn how to build a roller coaster if you have that kind of ability. You know, New Limits Part 2. Anything that keeps your mind thinking and going. Now, even if you have goals that are absurd and people have said throughout your life, forget about it. Keep your dreams alive to your dying breath. Don't let anyone tell you your dreams mean nothing. Keep those dreams alive until you die. I saw a very great saying about as long as you had, I don't know who said it, but it was near, I was at the foot of Flatbush Avenue with inside of the Manhattan Bridge. And there's a school there, I forget the name of the school, I've lived here long, but anyway, there was a saying outside the school, if you have dreams, you had something. So you want to stay young, keep your dreams alive, keep your goals alive, have goals. And finally, progressive ideas will keep you young, vibrant, and alive. Conservatism, and I don't mean conserving the forests, which is very, that's the only kind of conservation I believe in, where you preserve the natural world and we live in harmony with it. I'm saying, if you're a progressive, if your mind is progressively orientated, your brain is going to be more inclined to stay young. If it, not all the time, it could happen, and it will stay young. Because I find that conservatism and people who have those kind of thoughts and ideas do not have ideals. Do not have expansive, wonderful, harmonious, universal dreams of a all-inclusive universe. No. People who are conservative are basically constipated.